What's the plan for today, Dick?
Well, I got a mess of pines like this. Some of them smaller. I don't think anything bigger. I'm gonna see if I can mill them into some timber to build a sawmill shed out of. Let's see what we can do.
So how long?
We're not gonna get elaborate with it. This is that's like 16 foot right there.
Wow.
So we need about 10 foot height inside the shelter. So the idea is to, so that's the maximum height of the mill head is 8 foot, right around 8 foot. So we're figuring we could get that in there. That would give us 2 foot between that ceiling. We just need to get it out of the rain.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're thinking that we could mill these into some posts and build a little post and beam kind of shed. I don't think it'll be a permanent solution, but it'll be one that'll last us a couple of years or a few years anyway, until we figure out what we really want to do with this thing.
Mm-hmm.
We were looking at some timbers at Home Depot this morning, and 16 foot is about as good as you can get.
Right.
And after talking to the guy there, you know, he's like, "Hell, man, why don't you just mill some stuff you got?"
Yeah.
I'm like, you know, that's probably a good idea. We thought we needed to use pressure treated wood, but we're going to try this. This is not going to be some kind of permanent structure that you expect to last for 50 or 100 years. This is going to be something we're hoping, if we can get 10 years out of it, we'll be happy.
Right.
So we're going to do that. And we don't have a huge snow load here, so we don't have to worry about that.
And so kudos to the people at Home Depot, because they did. They spent a good amount of time talking.
Yeah, he did.
So, yeah.
I saw your stuff is new to us.
Yeah.
But we knew we needed a shelter, and we got burned. Somebody was going to build us a nice big 32 by 48 foot shop and then burned us. And so, out of desperation, we're going to go ahead and mill up something to build at least a temporary shelter. And by temporary, I mean semi-permanent, you know, something that we could tear down if the county comes and says, tear it down. But in the meantime, it should be plenty strong enough for to hold some metal or some Tuflex roof or something that we can keep the rain off of.
Right. And we're kind of using our fire shed as a mini example of what we can do. So
yes,
we've been kind of looking at that as we pass the barn there.
So we're thinking we'll make it like 16 by 28. Right?
Yeah.
Or 24. Well, it's the mill's like 26 foot.
Yeah.
So maybe we'll go 30.
And so maybe a little bit more of a slant than the firewood shed, but we'll see.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, yeah, we'll have to, because the 16 foot is going to have to be a little bit, we might have to build up the front a little bit. But then again, like I said, we don't get much of a snow load here.
Mm-mm.
So, I mean, you're lucky if you get 6 inches a year here.
Yeah.
You know, in a really bad year, you might get a 12-inch snowfall, and then the next day it's like 60. So, I mean, you don't really, you don't worry about that so much. So, I'm thinking I'm going to try to mill 4x6s. That might be the best we can do out of the wood we have. So, let's take a look. Looks like I could come down about, take this first slice off. I can come in about 6 inches here, right, and down to about here. And I might be able to, that's going to be close to get, I can probably get it. I know I can get 2 4x6s out of this thing. And I mean 4x6s. You know, if we went, I could do I might be able to get 2 6x6s, but probably not. Since most of the stuff over there is even smaller than this, we're probably, we should probably not. I want something a little bigger than 4x4, so we'll go with 4x6s, which is pretty much what that pole barn over there has in it.
Yeah, and they use some telephone poles, looks
that's
like.
They use telephone poles for the woodshed.
Oh, that's right, for the woodshed. So
they
you're talking
4x6s
for the barn. one, yeah. You can tell the difference between the one on the left is the one that we cut first. The one on the right is the one we just set down. So it loses its color really fast. All right, and then we're gonna go over here. We hope to find another 14-foot pine. Let's see if we can do it. We've done so good. We've done good so far. Woo! Chasing them. Falling down and chasing them. That one's too puny. Don't want that one. Looks pretty straight, maybe? Hard to tell. Oh, he's being rejected. Rejected. I think he's got his eye on something else.
When I came between the trees of the first log, it barely fit. And that was, and we had to cut that, so we had to cut a little bit, a couple feet off of that to get it down to our 14 length that we needed. So this one fit neatly between the trees, so it might be the same. Hopefully we got 14. All right, we're at 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14 foot 2 inches.
Which is what we... All right. Wow, we're like just getting them right in there, aren't we? Wow. All right, fantastic. Change your hats. Like Mr. Rogers.
And you know, this is helpful because I get hit in the face sometimes with stuff.
You do. keeping this going. Getting another log. I think this is her fourth log. I think it's her fourth log. And we have 5 of the 7 posts that we need for our sawmill shed. It's at least 14 feet long. Check. Well, maybe it's a keeper. All right. Looks like that baby is a keeper. Those 2 trees, so I think it'll be probably longer than our 14.